Hey everyone, I'm Howard Pinsky, Senior XD Evangelist at Adobe. Whether you want to add sound effects to improve your prototype's functionality, or to simply add a touch of fun, let's take a look at how that's done using Adobe XD. On a design like this, I may want to expand the interaction by adding not only speech playback, but sound effects as well. Starting off with the speech, when this artboard loads, I'd like the question at the top to be read back to me. To accomplish this, within prototype mode, I'll select the entire artboard and then click on the blue handle to the right. This will allow me to set up a time trigger that will take place after a short delay. Somewhere around 0.6 seconds should work. Under type, there are two options that we can use for this. Speech playback will let us choose a voice and enter the text that XD will read when previewing, or audio playback if you have a specific MP3 or WAV file that you'd like to use. My good friend Andrea Hawk recorded that question for me, so I'll select that file. Now, when the prototype is previewed...
When you create a repeat grid in Adobe XD, what are you required to say?
To add to this, it would be neat if, when an answer is selected, a chime of some sort would sound to indicate whether you're right or wrong. I've already set up the various states on the possible answers that will change the background color when tapped on, but now we need to add in some audio. Starting off with the incorrect answer, since 3 out of the 4 will use the same audio, I'm going to make sure to edit the master component to push the interactions to the rest. As you can see within the Properties Inspector, a tap trigger is already set up, but at the bottom, we can add in an additional action, where I can now browse Finder for the exact file I'd like to play, which in this case is the incorrect sound. Now that we have that in place, you'll notice that it's also present on the other incorrect answers. And since the correct component was overridden, I can jump in and choose the chime audio file I want to use. Perfect. Let's see this in action.
When you create a repeat grid in Adobe XD, what are you required to say?
Boop indeed. Finally, on a more playful note, I designed this BB-8 a while back, and to take it up a notch, I added in two audio files that plays back when it's tapped on. And that's a look at how you can use audio playback to take your prototypes to new levels. For more tips and tricks, head on over to letsxd.com and I'll see you all soon.